Happy winter solstice, everybody! You might be surprised to see your dear old gal Satan dressed like this, but today, I'm Satan Claus. Me and Santa go way back. I mean, who do you think he's calling? Ho, ho, ho. So I thought I'd do him a little favor and help pass out presents to all the naughty bands. And we got a lot of naughty bands this year. So come with me on my Satan holiday special.
Happy solstice, everyone. It's been an odd year. Not all of it's been good. So I think it's important we celebrate everything. But at the same time, don't forget, you gotta represent. So here's a little ditty I did a little diddlin' to. Hope you like it. I got a little dreidel, made it out of clay. And when it's dry and ready, then dreidel I shall play. Oh, dreidel, 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 I made it out of clay. And when it's dry and ready, then dreidel I will play. It's got a lovely body with legs short and thin. And when it gets all tired, it drops and I will win. Oh, dreidel, 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 I made it out of clay. Hey, hey. And when it's dry and ready, then dreidel I will play. My dreidel is so playful, loves to dance and spin. A happy game of dreidel, come on now, let's begin. Oh, dreidel, 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 I made it out of clay. And when it's dry and ready, then dreidel I will play. Shami, you sing if you are here. Niskadola, ya, po, you sing if you are there. Oh, dreidel, 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 I made it out of clay. Hey, hey. When it's dry and ready, then dreidel I will. Play. Happy solstice, happy Hanukkah. Merry Christmas, Kwanzaa. Celebrate what represents you, but celebrate everything else as best you can.
Here it is, the world premiere of
The Black Heartthrobs, Dinosaur Chris.
In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Who's got the biggest smile on Christmas Day? Dinosaur Chris. Dinosaur Chris, who helps Santa with his naughty list? Dinosaur Chris, Dinosaur Chris, late in the night while everyone sleeps. He's wide awake, sharpening his paws and his teeth. He plucks at trees like hairs from a brow, throws them so far till it reaches your town. He's got the biggest smile on Christmas Day. Dinosaur Chris, Dinosaur Chris. Santa with his naughty list. Dinosaur Chris, Dinosaur Chris. Then one smoggy Christmas Eve, Santa came to say, Dinosaur Chris, with your teeth so sharp, won't you help keep my naughty list short? And all the reindeers loved him. Christmas
Somos Misteriosos. Now, I gotta get to work on the naughty list. So stick around for Andrew Koch and the Twisted Black Soul. I didn't mean to say it like that.
Glasses fog up, he makes the temperature rise. I'm warning my friend, don't you look in his eyes, cause he's got hot eyes. Hot eyes. Hot eyes. It's not global warming, he's just looking at you. His eyes are like missiles and they're locked onto you. Can't explain the science behind it. It's just so simply magical. The flames of sex, you can't deny it. Coming from his pupils. Hot eyes. Hot eyes. Hot eyes. Hot eyes. He looks at your body, your clothes will catch fire. Can't explain the science behind it. It's just so
Great job, guys. Up next we have... Do you hear that? Somebody's calling me on Zoom. Even though my away message says to fuck off. Let's see who it is.
Hello.
Hello, you look amazing.
Thank you.
Wow, a Mrs. C with green hair. You are more Christmas than Mrs. Claus. She doesn't have green hair.
She ain't got nothing on me.
She got nothing on you. Yes, you look amazing. Hey, you got time for a magic trick?
For you, always.
For this to work, I'm going to bring down my camera. Calm down, no mace, please. I'm just going to change the angle so that hopefully you can step into my office. I'm going to bring the camera down. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, here we go. Excellent. Can you see? Let's see, I might even put it on gallery so I can see what the hell I'm doing. Okay, can you see the deck of cards and my pad and my wiggly fingers?
Yes, all 10.
Yes, excellent. Oh, thank you. I'm not here to do math, so thanks for the backup. All right, and I've got this mysterious box. Oh, it's almost like it's like a dark Christmas present. You appreciate that, don't you, Caitlin?
My favorite kind.
Right? Okay, so we're going to start with the deck. Now, the deck is in no particular order, but you don't have to take my word for it. Oh, no. You're going to help me mix it up. I'm going to say go. I'm going to run through the cards. You say stop wherever you wish, okay? Go.
Stop.
Ooh, takes a long time for you to say stop. Fun on dates. Fun on dates. I'm going to have to remember that. Okay. Wow. Mr. C is a lucky man. Okay. All right. Say stop.
Stop.
Okay. And say stop.
Stop.
Oh, one more time.
Stop.
Oh, okay. A little, I know we got a bit of a lag on Zoom, so a little faster, Mrs. C.
All right.
Go.
Stop.
Okay, good. All right. Are we good?
Yes.
Okay, good. Okay, cool. So, Mrs. C, since you and your husband, you warp the laws of time and space. I'm not sure what I'm doing with my fingers right now. It looks like someone having a seizure, maybe playing the piano, maybe both. But let's just pretend this means, you know, warping the laws of time and space. So we're going to play with time. We're going to create a clock around the deck in the order that you left it in.
Okay.
So first we need an hour out of that clock. And as you know, the hours go like this, and we're actually going to go backward in time. So imagine this with me, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So, Caitlin, Mrs. C, I want you to think of one of those numbers. Now, it may be the number that you ultimately choose. It'd be interesting to find out, because check this out. I'm going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm just going to run through these cards, and you say stop. And neither you nor I will know for sure where exactly you said stop, but that will represent an hour on our clock. And this will make a little more sense in a minute.
Okay.
So I'm going to say go, and as you can notice, we only have 12 cards instead of 52, so this is going to go super fast, Mrs. C.
I'll do my best.
Okay, all right. Go, say stop, go.
Stop.
Oh, good. Now, I believe you said stop here, but do you want me to go one up, one down, or stay there? It's your call.
Stay there.
Stay there. You commit. Wow. Unlike my exes. That's good to know. Okay, so you said stay here. I'm going to try to keep this in frame, and there may be no better place than right there.
Okay.
And as I said, I want you to envision the hours of the clock, maybe even a specific hour. Maybe the hour you're thinking of matches the number of cards that you said stop at. We don't know, but we're going to find out. Are you ready?
Yes.
All right, so here we go. Watch this. Like I said, we're going to go back in time, back to that moment where I asked you to envision the clock, maybe even think of a specific hour. So this will be 12, this will be 11, this will be 10. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to try to keep our dark, mysterious present in frame as well. This will be 9. And again, I'm keeping your pile intact. This will be 8, this will be 7, this will be 6. And Mrs. C, if I had the honor of you sitting next to me, like if we were at the Magic Castle, you would be doing this all yourself.
Ooh.
So it's very unusual. Yeah, I would never touch the cards again. You would be in control. You dig that, don't you, Mrs. C?
It's the only way I know how to live.
I know, right? I picked that up on your OnlyFans. So, so you would be the only person touching the cards. So just watch me and make sure I'm doing what exactly that I claim that I'm doing. 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Yes.
Okay. And again, I have touched this pile that you created. I can make a wild guess how many cards it is. I can make a guess what hour it might represent. What is your guess?
Six.
So that's not a bad guess. Okay, let's find out. Okay, check this out. Hey, can I show you what's inside the mystery present box?
Ooh. Yes.
Yeah, excellent. Look at this, 3D. I've spared no expense for you, Mrs. C. 3D. I love it. Ooh, it's a pendulum. And have you ever done pendulum work before, Mrs. C?
You know, I dabble here and there.
You've been known to dabble. A little dabble, do you? Okay, that's cool. So, as you know, a lot of people use pendulums to actually make choices, right? So I'm going to, you said six. Let me hang it over six. I don't see a lot happening there, but it's a good guess. Maybe it's close. Give me another hour, Mrs. C.
Five.
Five, okay. Nothing there. How about another hour, please?
Three.
Three, okay. And keep going.
I guess I should have probably done four.
Okay, that's okay. Yeah, you don't have to go in order. You just tell me random, and you're gonna try to match this pile, but again, it doesn't have to be perfect. Just guess.
Seven.
So that's four, seven. Go.
Ooh.
Mrs. C, now unfortunately my hand's out of frame, but I'm actually not moving my hand at all. But as you know with pendulum work, sometimes it's an idiomotor response.
Mm-hmm.
Some people debate what it is, but I definitely see movement here that was not there before. Agreed?
Yes. Agreed.
Okay, check. Agreed. Excellent. Check this out. All right. So that represents 7 o'clock. Shall we take a look at the numbers of cards that you selected?
Yes.
Okay, and again, if I had the honor of you sitting next to me, Caitlin, Mrs. C, you would pick up the cards, you would count these yourself. So just watch, make sure I'm doing exactly what I'm saying I'm doing.
Okay.
Here's one. So count with me, please. Okay.
One,
two, three, four, five, six. Hey, look at that.
What?
And you guessed six, which was super close,
yeah.
But then the pendulum went crazy over the seven, and turns out that's exactly the choice that you made. But check this out, this pendulum is very special. Can I show you?
Yeah.
It actually has an inscription. Hey, Caitlin, just out of curiosity, what is your favorite card in the deck?
Three of clubs.
Three of clubs. Can I show you what is inscribed on the timepiece, on the pendulum?
Yes.
Can you see that?
That's so cool.
No, I'm hopped up on Red Bull, so this might be shaking a little bit. But yeah, I think you can see
that awesome.
It says, not only is it your favorite card, it literally says you chose your favorite card. Is that correct?
Yes.
Hey, there's only one way to find out. Shall we turn over 7 o'clock?
Yeah.
Boom. Look at that. Look at that.
That's
look
amazing.
At that. You're amazing, Mrs. C. All right, but wait, I got to be honest.
Mm-hmm.
This is super cool. I mean, it matched the number that you chose. It matched the prediction on the timepiece. It happened to be your favorite card. It was right there on the hour that you chose. As cool as that is, I didn't actually show you the rest of the deck, did I?
No.
This is true.
Oh,
yeah, thanks for heckling. Yeah, okay, so you're absolutely right, Mrs. C. You're absolutely right, Caden. I didn't show you the rest of the deck. But if this is really magic, then all of this should be true. You had no choice but to choose 7 cards. The pendulum had no choice but to choose the seventh hour. And the seventh hour had to be the 3 of clubs, which had to be the prediction on the pendulum, which had to be your favorite card. And do you know why, Mrs. C?
Why?
Because this card technically isn't a card at all. Can I show you the rest of the cards that you chose?
Yeah. What?
The cards don't exist. Mrs. C, can I show you 12 o'clock, midnight, noon?
Yeah. Stop.
I'm still going. Shall we go back in time? Here's 11. Here's 10. Here's 9. Here's 8. Here's 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. What about the rest of the deck? Should we look?
Oh, my God.
Mrs. C, there's not a single card in the deck. which means it's the only card you could have selected. And not only did it match your hour and your choice and the prediction on the timepiece, it also happens to be your favorite card. Is that correct?
That is insane. Yes.
Guys, those of you at home, even if you're on mute, I think she deserves, what does she deserve? She deserves some applause. 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 Yeah. No, more. More. No. Okay. Louder. Okay. All right. Thanks. All right. That's enough. Kat, it is such an honor to see you. It's wonderful to work with you and Blake, and happy late Krampus and happy holidays to you. It's so good to see you.
Magician, everybody. Wasn't that great? Up next, we have Gretel Bonilla and Reactants. Stick around.
Music,
have John Franco and the Black Heartthrobs. Stick around, because if you stop watching, I don't get paid. Good luck on tying this.
Oh, John Franco. Merry Christmas. Happy Hanukkah. Feliz Navidad. And happy winter solstice. Here's a carol for you to sing along with. Good night. Happy rest of your new year. Happy rest of your new year. Happy rest of the year. Stay safe. Wash your hands. Be good. Bye.
Want to get to this other topic? So in Slate, they have a piece on .com. Santa Claus should not be a white man anymore. And when I saw this headline, I kind of laughed. I thought, this is so ridiculous. Yet another person claiming it's racist to have a white Santa, you know? And by the way, for all you kids watching at home, Santa just is white, but this person is just arguing that maybe we should also have a black Santa. But Santa is what he is, and just so you know, we're just debating this because someone wrote about a kid. Okay, wanted to get that straight. But Jedediah, when I read the piece, the author seems to have, you know, she's African-American, and she seems to have real image of a white Santa, and she speaks about it kind of honestly, saying, I didn't really understand.
thinking, oh, this is more politically correct, not censored, this is hypersensitivity in our culture. And then you read the piece and you really walk through the steps with her. I think it's a tribute to her writing. And you realize if you were a young kid and you were African American and your Santa Claus was white, it would affect you when you went to school. Maybe you wouldn't feel that you were part of that tradition. Now, she suggests that a penguin should be Santa. Okay, and then she goes off the rails. Well, I think it's kind of interesting, though, to have an animal, which is something that kids love, sort of brings that cartoonish component into it. And I think that makes all kids kind of feel welcome in the process. So I knew where she was going with that.
No, don't
be wrong.
So I've given her name's Aisha Harris. I've given her her, you know, her due on where she was going with it. But just because it makes you feel uncomfortable doesn't mean, you know, I mean, Jesus was a white man too. But, you know, it's like, he was a historical figure. I mean, that's a verifiable fact, as is Santa. I just want kids watching to know that. Yeah, but my point is, how do you just revise it, you know, in the middle of the legacy of the story and change Santa from white to black?
Fun, but I gotta get back to work. Let's see who's up next on this naughty list. We got John Zadok, Twisted Black Soul, and Stevie Wonder Bread. Oh. Yeah, it's onions. Do you know what the price of coal is these days? Stick around.
Hey kids, it's time for a sing-along. This is a song I wrote for a friend I love, but she's never seen me perform. This song's called Kimmy is a Bitch. Here we go. I know a girl from the Gateway City doesn't have an ounce of pity. If she had a twin, she'd be the evil one. She'd take a Sharpie and black out the sun. 'Cause Kimmy is a bitch. She's as mean as the Wicked Witch. She'll kick you while you're lying in a ditch. 'Cause Kimmy is a bitch. She's a vegetarian who doesn't like vegetables. And she sings crude songs at the dinner table. She'll stick her finger in your water glass. And if you get mad, she'll say, kiss my ass. 'Cause Kimmy is a bitch. She's as mean as the Wicked Witch. She'll kick you while you're lying in a ditch. 'Cause Kimmy is a bitch. She comes with a warning on eHarmony. She'd even mug the tooth fairy. All the kids in town say she's really mean, 'cause she beats them up and takes their jelly beans. 'Cause Kimmy is a bitch. She's as mean as the Wicked Witch. She'll kick you while you're lying in a ditch. 'Cause Kimmy is a bitch. She's not just mean, she's also cheap. She thinks a dollar store is pretty steep. She'll go to a bar, order water and chips, 'cause there's no way in hell she's leaving a tip. 'Cause Kimmy is a bitch. She's as mean as the Wicked Witch. She'll kick you while you're lying in a ditch. 'Cause Kimmy is a bitch. Now, I know what your kids are thinking. You can't sing that song. It's got a bad word. But the truth is, it's all true. And Kimmy loves this song. And you know what else Kimmy loves? She loves attention. So she would love it if you sang along. And don't worry, when you sing with love, there's no bad words. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4. Kimmy is a bitch. She's is as mean as the Wicked Witch. So kick you while you're lying in a ditch, cause Kimmy is a bitch. That was good, that was really good. But I know deep inside your heart wasn't into it. That's because you don't know Kimmy. That's understandable. But we all have a Kimmy. We all have that friend that we love so much that sometimes we just gotta say, that person's a bitch. So you put the name of your bitch friend in there, okay? And don't worry, it doesn't have to be gender specific. We know what happens in prison, okay, kids? Here we go. I'm still gonna sing Kimmy though. 1, 2, 3, 4. Kimmy is a bitch. She's as mean as the Wicked Witch. So kick you while you're lying in a ditch, cause Kimmy is a bitch. One more time. Kimmy is a bitch. She's as mean as the Wicked Witch. So kick you while you're lying in a ditch, cause Kimmy is a bitch. You guys did so good. Happy holidays, everybody. Shalom.
East. It's already been Halloween time and time for Thanksgiving feasts. And your good old friend, Stevie Wonderbread, has had a lot of time to reflect. Missing some good friends and family very dearly. 2020 I did not expect. But you know, everyone's got their own problems and pains that this year has touched. I just want to let you all know that I miss you and love you very, very much. So here's a toast to you as I get sentimental with a song. Merry Christmas, Happy New Year, and please don't be afraid to sing along. Woo! Christmas.
Well, another successful winter solstice under our belts. I want to thank all the bands for performing with us tonight. And, you know, I feel like if I can get a little personal, Blake and I have had our disagreements in the past, I'm sure you all know. But what better way to end 2020 than bearing the hatchet? So I got you a little gift, Blake, if I may. I wonder what it could be. It's your favorite, a shirt. Thanks for having me, Blake. I'll see you next year.